One night, Percy and Bruno are at the Smudger Station Harbor taking the mail train. Percy was taking the mail train with Bruno the brake van coupled behind. While Percy waited for his mail trucks to be loaded, he talked to Steamer 10 Cents. He was telling him about the time where he was put upon at the coal mines. And then Scruffy and the trucks crash into the other part of the coal mines, and then the mines collapse. I backed up to the barrier by the track, and I made it just in time. Wow, you were so brave. Yeah, I was, and it was brave like when I ended up having to go across the flood when I was taking passengers for Thomas. Me and Annie Clairbo went through the flood, and we made it to the other side, thanks to Harold. Wow! And everyone noticed you also took a special delivery, Percy. Wow, what special? Well, 10 cents, my special delivery is a magic carpet. I once noticed it, and it ended up, and it came down and right onto one of Murdoch's trucks when he was taking a freight train, and I followed him. But then the magic carpet went off again, and it went on to the top of Toby. But then when me and Toby got to Kelsorp Station, the carpet went off and came down onto the track. And then we noticed Thomas was coming. He was on the same track as the carpet. But then the carpet went off again, and it ended up onto my truck. Wow, that was awesome. Indeed it was, Steamer. Who was that? Whose whistle is that? I'm not sure what it is, Bruno. I'm not sure, Steamer. I'm a brake fan. I don't know whose whistle is that. Percy, there's something onto the bridge. What? What do you mean by a 10 cents? Percy looked, and there appeared was an engine Percy had ever noticed. Wait, there's an engine on the bridge, and it sort of looks like the engine that Edward told me and the others about, which is the ghost engine returns to the smelter's yard looking for its lost whistle! Before Percy could say anything else, the engine disappeared without saying anything else. So, that's Edward's ghost engine? Yeah, Bruno, and I heard he used to be at Bertram Station. That he is disguised as the City of Churro in a GWR tank engine. It's true. And Smudger had talked to him for a little bit, which Edward's ghost engine doesn't understand what he's saying, but he sort of talked to him. Indeed. Oh wow, I gotta go tell Thomas and the others about this. As soon as the mail cars were loaded to Percy's trucks, Percy went off, feeling a bit worried. Oh, it's gonna be a crazy day. Indeed, Percy, indeed. I think it's gonna be a long night, Steamer. All I know is that it's gonna be so difficult for the others. Yeah, but I'm sure Smudger Tim Barnett will deal with Edward's ghost engine. But I'm not sure Sir Topham Hatt will notice it. Like, he's gonna notice that it's gonna be difficult for them. And Smudger and Tim Barnett try to tell Sir Topham Hatt, but he's not sure. And I'm just not sure. But all I notice, 10 cents, that it's gonna be a crazy night for one of the engines. I just know it. You know what? I think you're right, and it's gonna be difficult. It's gonna be a long night for them. Indeed. a long night. Later in the morning, Percy talked to Thomas about it. Thomas was surprised to notice him. So, you noticed Edward's ghost engine at the bridge on the other part of the line near the Smudger Station Harbor?
I did notice it, Thomas. It had really surprised me, Bruno, Tencent, and Steamer.
Wow. I didn't know he was still around. Do you think he already moved on when he already found its whistle?
I don't know, Thomas. I did notice it came back. Like, Edward's ghost engine came back, and it's like he always comes back. Like, I just don't know. I just felt unsure about it.
Oh. I guess I understand that it's like that.
I know. So weird, isn't it?
It is, Percy. I'm surprised that you noticed it. And it's like it's been crazy since I heard its whistle when I was left at the smelter's yard, when you and Doug left me at the smelter's yard.
I know. And I'm sorry about that. And it looks like you did hear Edward's ghost engine's whistle.
I totally did, Percy, but it's okay. I forgive you, because you're still my friend.
You noticed it?
Of course I do, Percy. You're still my friend, and you always will be.
Thanks, Thomas.
But Percy was a bit unsure what else to Edward's ghost engine. Before Thomas could say anything else, Thomas's driver came and went back into his cab.
Sorry, Thomas, but we have to go. Annie and Clarabelle are waiting for you.
Oh, sorry, I have to go, Percy. But I promise everything will be okay, and I'll see you later. And with that, Thomas went off.
I hope Edward Ghost Engine doesn't attack me alive. Or even attack me totally alive. I just don't want to die from Edward's ghost engine. I just don't want to die from him.
Percy, it's okay. It's okay. I know what you're thinking, but be brave, Percy. I know you will fight him. He might be still out there, but you will fight him. Thomas knows you got this. And I know your sister Liz knows you got this.
You're right. My sister Liz knows I got this. And she knows I have the courage to try.
Percy was a bit worried, but he knew his sister Liz believes in him. But it wasn't Percy that noticed Edward's ghost engine. News had spread about it. And everyone noticed it on the news. They noticed reports about Edward's ghost engine, that everyone noticed it. And most of them are a bit worried. And everyone had heard about it on the news. Then, news spread down the line. Later, when Duke and Steamer heard about it, they were worried.
So, do you think Edward's ghost engine's still around after Tim Barnett had dealt with him since he was at Gerald's hometown?
I don't know, Duke, but this is so difficult, and I felt unsure about it, and I just noticed it's going to be difficult.
I agree, Steamer. This is going to be so difficult. I think Smudger and Tim Barton already knows about it.
You know what? I think you're right, Duke. I think Smudger had heard about it and that he is worried.
Duke and Steamer were a bit unsure, but they noticed it's gonna be difficult. I had noticed most of it when I heard about it, when me and Smudger heard about that he is still around. Like, I heard lots about it, and I also heard your encounter with Edward's ghost engine, Thomas, when you were at the Smudger's yard, when I heard about it. And I'm surprised that Edward's ghost engine's still around. It is true, I did hear its whistle, and all I did is just head back to Timochette's, but me and the others heard about it when Edward told us about his ghost engine. And I'm surprised that Smudger did notice him.
Do you think Sir Topman knows? Indeed, Annie, I'm just not sure.
I know it's difficult, but I'm sure we'll get through this.
Well, it is true. When I was taking pastures at Brendan Docks, Everett's ghost engine went past me when he went across the crossing. And it did surprise me a little.
Well, at least you're okay, Birdie.
Yeah, and I think we should keep an eye on him until later.
You know what? I think you're right, Thomas. I'm sure we'll keep an eye on him. Anyways, I gotta go. I gotta get those pastures to the other part of my branch line, and then I gotta get those pastures back to Nafford Station. I'll see you later, Tim Barnett. I hope I don't bump into Edward's ghost engine again.
Don't worry, Thomas, you'll be fine.
Thank you, Annie, and thanks, Clarabelle. Anyways, I'm going to let Smudger know something weird is gonna happen. Eventually, and I feel like the worst is about to come. I just know it. I think you're right, and oh, it's gonna make my wheels rattle to notice it. Be brave, Birdie. I'm sure Smudger and I will deal with Edward's ghost engine. He might be still out there, but I'm sure we'll try to deal with him. Later, night had came and Gordon was talking to 17 and Philip before he gets ready to take the express.
Are you sure he really heard the ghost whistle, Gordon?
I don't know, Philip. Percy did tell me and he thought Wyatt is messing with him. And then he noticed an engine that passed by. I don't know what it was, but he's told me that it looks like Edward's ghost engine. But I don't know. He told me that it looks like another engine that looks the same as Henry, but just passed by.
Wow, that's weird.
And before Philip could say anything else, it started to came down. A storm had came.
What? I didn't know it was storming.
It could be the storm coming early. I didn't know it could come this early.
I know, Gordon. That is so weird.
And Gordon noticed it was. Meanwhile, James was taking a late night pasture train. He was excited. A splatter at an engine like me is gonna be on time. And nothing is gonna get in the way. I don't know, James, anything could happen. And before James' driver could say anything else, James just stopped. And then he also noticed something.
James? James? Are you okay? Driver? There's an engine in front of us! and James noticed it. There was Edward's ghost engine. What's going on? And I don't know who the heck is that engine, but it might be Edward's ghost engine. Before James noticed anything else, it happened.
I don't notice it, but during it, I noticed it's been difficult. And then later, I was at the Smudger's yard before I went there. I used to be really useful, and I was happy, and noticed my friends, and I often pulled passengers and freight trains. And then later, when I was taking some trucks full of scrap to the Smudger's yard, I got into an accident, all because of my brakes, and it had caused a lot of problems. Like it got just corrupted! And all I noticed, except the part where I noticed Smudger.
Noticed Smudger? Oh yeah! Bertram Station! Wait, you know him?
That's right. I noticed Smudger when I was at Bertram Station. And I tried looking for my lost whistle at Bertram Station, and I don't know where it's at.
This is going out of nowhere, James. We really need to go. Before James's driver could say anything else, Edward's ghost engine noticed it.
And it happened. So, I heard I surprised Thomas when he was at the Smudger's yard when Percy and Doug left him there. And I was trying to let him know. And then I noticed it's just been difficult. So, where's my lost whistle? I want to know where it's at.
My whistle!
Okay, let's go, driver. This is going insane!
And before anything else happens, James went off, heading back to the other part of the line. He was spooked when he noticed Edward's ghost engine.
I guess I put him under a lot of pressure. But later the others will notice it. And later they'll notice what I'm looking for. And later I'll see Smudger again. Eventually.
Later the next day, James talked to Edward and Nia about it. Some craziest thing that ever happened. Are you sure your mind is just messing with you?
But I'm not kidding! I did notice Edward's ghost engine. It really surprised me. And I don't know what else happened. All I did is just noticed it and he talked to me and things had went insane a little bit. I don't know what it was, Edward and Nia, but it just scared the crap out of me.
I think it was probably looking for its whistle still. And I think it must have surprised you. And I heard Smudger did notice him when he was at Bertram Station when he was disguised as the City of Truro and the GWR tank engine. Maybe you should talk to Smudger about it.
Smudger? Are you sure?
I'm sure he'll help you.
I'm not sure, but you know what, Edward? You're right. I'm going to talk to Smudger. I think I need some help. And maybe Smudger will know what's going on.
And with that, James just went off.
Smudger will help me, I'm sure. Edward's ghost engine probably had some problems. And I'm sure Smudger will know what's going on. And with that, James just went off.
Thank you.
didn't know about your ghost engine, so can you tell me? Actually, Nia, I think I'll tell you later, because I got some patches to take later. Oh, okay, maybe later then. I guess it also explains the stuff that Steamer told me what he noticed last night. I think you're right, Nia. I think things are gonna be difficult. Eventually. Later, James talked to Glitchy, and James was at Potterton Station waiting for his trucks to be loaded with supplies to take to Brendan Docks. James talked to Glitchy about where he noticed Edward's ghost engine. And then things got crazy and I decided to back away from Edward's ghost engine. And it was insane. Wow. At least you got the passengers back to the station, James. At least the passengers are saved. Yeah, that's a relief. So, you noticed Edward's ghost engine? Yeah, Cassim, I did. Well, I heard about it, and I'm surprised that you already noticed it. You noticed it too, Cassim? Of course I did, Glitchy. When I was busy with stuff, I heard about reports about Edward's ghost engine, and then I heard that his whistle had been knocked off, and that he ended up into the smelter's pit when he became a runaway. Wow, that's what happened? Yeah, I heard about it, James. You heard about it, Glitchy? Yeah, and I heard he was disguised as the city of Churro, and he could shift into engines. Wow. Like, he's disguised as the city of Churro when he was at Bertram Station along with the GWR tank engine? Yeah, I heard Smudger talk to him. Just a little bit. Yeah, and I think you better keep an eye out for anything, James. And especially you, Glitchy. Thanks, Cassim. We'll keep an eye on everything. At last, the supplies were loaded into James's trucks, and James went off. He was still a bit worried about Edward's ghost engine, and he was a bit unsure. I hope James doesn't bump into him again. Don't worry, Cassim. I'm sure James will be fine. I think. Later, Sir Topham Head is getting a lot of phone calls and reports about Edward's ghost engine. I know! He's still around! I already know! And soon, they will deal with him. And if I may call, James had noticed Edward's ghost engine and he went back to the station after he noticed he went insane. Oh, first Thomas and then James. And I don't know what's going on. Sir, I think you should let Smudger and Tim Barnett do it. Tim Barnett already deal with Edward's ghost engine at Gerald's hometown. I already knew that, and later he will. Just give me some time. Okay, I'll just send those reports to the other part of the line. And don't worry, I'm sure they already know. And don't worry, I'll also send it to my laptop. And I'll let them know. Make sure they let them know to keep an eye out for anything weird or anything mysterious going on. Don't worry, sir, I won't. Don't know what's going on. But I realized it's really going to be difficult for my engines. I just knew it. And with that, Sir Topham Head left his office feeling a bit worried. Later, James talked to Smudger and Steamer about it. It's like what you said, Smudger. I noticed it. It's the same thing that I noticed. The one that Edward told me about it when Thomas Percy Duck left to the smelter's yard. And I did notice it, and I shouldn't have been so honest with you. And I just don't know what to do. James, Smudger and I knows you could deal with him. I noticed something, and I don't know where he's at, but I heard he's somewhere on the mainland. There's a scrapyard on the mainland. The one where Rusty had saved Stepney from scrap. I think that's where he's going. Jinx and Pug are probably there. They could be in trouble. Then that's where I will go. That way I could help Edward's ghost engine so that I won't have to deal with his problems. A splendid red engine like me will deal with them. Wait, if you're going, then I'm going with you. Why, Edward? Because I'm going to help you. Okay, I understand. Let's go. And with that, James and Edward started off, and they went off to the mainland. I think we gotta help them, Smudger. I think. Wait for me, James! Hurry up! I got to put an end to it before things get worse. James! I know you're upset, but I'm sure there's another way. Know where you're at, Edward's ghost engine, and come on and show yourself. James waited for Edward's ghost engine. Well, are you gonna show yourself? Wow. James, we meet again. That's right, and I know what you did to Thomas, and I know what you almost did to Tim Barnett. You don't have to keep doing this. You already found your whistle. And sure, you also tried to get Tim Barnett, but all of it's over now. Why can't you just leave Tim Barnett alone? You already found your whistle, so just back off.
Just told me to? You did not just say that.
Just did. And nobody messes with my friends.
That's right. James said it.
Oh. Smudger. We meet again.
Of course we did.
Because it's been a while since I talked to you at Bertram Station. And since Tim Barnett deal with you at Gerald's hometown. I see you came back. It's still powerful than ever. That's because everyone knows I'm a real useful supernatural engine.
Guess what? I'm powerful than you'll ever be.
What? No, this can't be.
Oh yeah, it's happening. And you won't cause any more trouble anymore. lightning bolts went everywhere around Edward's ghost engine. It's over, Edward's ghost engine, and you don't have to keep doing this anymore. And Smudger uses powers, and then Edward's ghost engine disappears. Alright, James. I think so, Smudger. Oh, I am so sorry. I was just wanna deal with Edward's ghost engine and I got in the way. I'm sorry. But James, you didn't! You helped Smudger! I did? Of course you did, James. You helped me deal with Edward's ghost engine. You distracted him. You did so well. You're a splendid red engine. You were brave to deal with him. And don't worry, James. Everyone will always know that you will always be the splendid red engine. Indeed. And Sir Topham will be so happy about this, and he'll be very happy to hear about it. Let's go home. I think you had a lot to talk about. Well, I wish I could, Smudger, but I'm out of coal. Don't worry, James. I could help with that. I'll use teleportation to get here. I'll use my powers to teleport back to Krogan's Gate. That will be awesome. Smudger, Blue as Whistle, and James, Edward, and Smudger teleported back to Krogan's Gate. James was happy that he had been really useful. So Topham had hear about it, he decided to have James take passenger trains, and he often allowed James to share the fare. James doesn't mind. He was happy that he has been brave, and he knew he had been really useful. Later, James talked to Gordon and Henry about it. Gordon had heard about it, and he felt sorry for James.
Looks like you surely showed Edward's ghost engine that you're brave.
Yep, a splendid red engine like me. Always been brave. And it was thanks to Smudger. Without his help, it could have been worse. Smudger had been a really useful supernatural engine. At least you noticed that. I did indeed, Henry. And James, Gordon, and Henry laughed. And soon, they went to sleep. But not James. He was still awake, and he was still been thinking about what happened. I guess Edward's ghost engine's probably still around or something. I'm just not sure. Can't worry about it. Everything's fine, he's already dealt with, and I already got it. And James noticed he didn't worry about it. He had noticed that he had been brave and knew things had been fine. He thought that things were fine, and James think it has been difficult, but he knew things have been fine. And he thought dealing with Edward's ghost engine really worked being really useful and having the courage to try.
I'm sure it was, don't you?
And it looks like James already got it. Did he? Well, at least James had been brave, and it looks like he did have the courage to try. And I think he did. Looks like he had been really useful and brave.